going, people? Myke C-Town here. Happy Metal Monday. So today I'm going to talk about two metal albums. The first one I'm going to talk about is the latest album. I feel so lame even saying this. The latest album from Cradle of Filth, entitled Hammer of the Witches. So I'll start by saying this. I was a huge fan of Cradle of Filth, like most people, back in 96, I guess. Back when I first heard Dusk in Her Embrace. You know, it was something new and something different. It was mysterious, evil, all that. You know, and I liked them up until Midian, and after that, I kind of lost interest. I feel like Midian was the last good album they put out, and they were pretty much shit for the next 15 years. Fast forward, and I randomly decided to check out a post on a new Cradle of Filth track, and it was Deflowering the Maidenhead, Displeasuring the Goddess. And I was actually really surprised at how good I thought it was. I didn't absolutely love it, but, you know, from this track, I figured the album was at least worth giving a listen when it dropped. And when I listened to it, wow, man. I was actually blown away by how much I enjoyed it. It's a total return to what I actually enjoyed about Cradle of Filth back in the day. The cool riffs, the interestingly laid out tracks, you know, lots of cheesy goth sensibilities, but I realize that Cradle of Filth is like the Good Charlotte of black metal, you know? But I'm not gonna lie and say that they don't have some good albums. I loved Principle Evil Made Flesh. Vampyr, the EP, is still my favorite released by them. Of course, I love Dusk in Her Embrace. You know, I loved all those albums, and when Yours Immortally, the first track from this album, when that starts out, it sounds like vintage Cradle of Filth. It's a great riff, fast drumming, and those cheesy fucking like chamber goth keyboards that come in. And when Danny Filth comes in with his patented screech, man, I'm taken back to 96 when I really loved this band. This song really sounds like something that could have been on Dusk in Her Embrace. And you know, the record to me stays good from there. You know, I can honestly say there's not a down moment on the album, not a skippable track. You know, all the tracks held my attention, and they keep the album moving forward very nicely. The guitars are really what kept my attention. They're really well done with some really, really catchy riffs. It's interesting that Paul Allender leaves the band, and we get two completely new guitarists, Richard Shaw and Marek Smyrda, who, from what I understand, were originally just live musicians for the band. You know, these guys come in, and the original spirit of Cradle of Filth is renewed. You know, it's like these guys studied the greats like Dusk and Cruelty and the Beast, and they set out to restore people's faith in the band. Like these guys really work extremely well together, and they managed to put together a really cohesive project, you know, making you not even really notice that they're newcomers. Right Wing of the Garden Triptych is probably my favorite track. You know, I love the intro to the song. I love the way the guitars come in. Again, it's just vintage Cradle of Filth. I spoke about Deflowering the Maidenhead earlier, but this is another really, really good track. A fantastic main riff, those great, cheesy female vocals done by Lindsay Schoolcraft is her name, who, from what I understand, this is the first album that she's been on with Cradle of Filth. I'm not really sure what happened to Sarah Jezebel Diva. I'm not sure when she left or why she left or if she's doing other things, and I just really, honestly, I didn't care to look it up. What's great is this album makes it to where real metalheads can like this band again. You know, it's no longer just cheesy fucking mall goths and Hot Topic heshers that can be proud Cradle of Filth fans. We can finally stop saying, well, I only really like their old stuff. Because if you like their old stuff, I can't see why you wouldn't like this album. Because, you know, it could be that I'm enjoying it so much because they've given us nothing but bullshit for the past 6 albums, and since this one is actually decent, it makes me like it that much more. But whatever the reason, I am really, really, really enjoying this new Cradle of Filth album, and I hope this is the beginning of a new Cradle of Filth. You know, a new Cradle of Filth playing what made them so good so many years ago. But honestly, I think it's almost ridiculous and almost unreasonable how much I like this new album and how often I listen to it. So I say, if you're a fan of what Cradle of Filth was doing back in the day with, again, with Dusk and Cruelty, and even maybe Midian, I think you should give this new album a shot. I really think they're trying to go for that core, that original Cradle of Filth sound, and they do it extremely well. I'm not saying this is the best album they've done. I'm not even saying this will be counted as one of the best albums that they've done. But what I'm saying is, it's a solid album, it's a good listen, and it's definitely a return to form for the band. The next album we're going to talk about is Black Funeral's Vampyr, Throne of the Beast. I first found this album way back when I first started getting into black metal in the late 90s. I didn't know shit about black metal, and the only bands I really knew were bands like the popular ones, like Cradle of Filth, Emperor, Marduk, Dark Funeral, Demi Borgir, that kind of shit. You know, and I didn't realize there was this whole underground scene to rifle through, and I can't remember where I got this CD, but this album started my love of super raw and gross black metal. To me, that's what this album embodies. Super raw, gross, and ugly, just disgusting black metal. Black Funeral is a band from Houston, Texas, of all places. You know, they're probably still my favorite U.S. black metal band with Judas Iscariot close behind. But this is their first full length. It was on Full Moon Productions, and it's some of the most interesting and well-played black metal to come out of the U.S. You know, there is some real feeling and depth to this album. It's not just a bunch of tremolo picking and blast beats and blah. There's a lot of interesting riff work here and complex time changes, which is not very common in the necro, the more ugly and super underground sounding black metal. If you listen to a song like The Floating Blue Witchcraft, that song has so much stuff going on. From riff to riff, you really have no idea what to expect next. The same goes for a song like Spectral Agony of Pain and Loneliness. You know, the interesting switch up of riffs, the time changes, it's just really good songwriting that shows off how crafty these guys can be, you know, while remaining within the confines of what true and cult black metal can be. And it does this without sounding mathy or like tech deathy. You know, it's just black metal done where the guitar players actually want to play some real riffs. The vocals done by Baron Draconian Abaddon are definitely something to notice here. They are truly crazed and just pained sounding. The guy sounds like he seriously gargled razors before recording this. There are a few ambient pieces sprinkled in here and there, and they definitely add to the central vampiric theme of the album. They're dark and they're spooky with the perfect amount of corniness in them, and they make it that much better when the actual black metal comes back in. I can say the only gripe that I have for this album is that it's so short. It clocks in at a little bit under 30 minutes. But it's the best close to 30 minutes of black metal I've ever heard. You know, there's no showing off here. There's no shrills. There's no epicness to it. It's just straight up filthy necro black metal, but with a lot of feeling and a lot of emotion put into it. You know, if I had to give my all-time top 10 favorite black metal albums ever, this would easily be in there, because to me it embodies what black metal is. You know, the darkness, the filth, the evil. I could listen to this anytime I'm in the mood for black metal. It reminds me, I used to have this great Black Funeral Vampyr t-shirt, and I don't remember where I got it or why in the motherfuck I got rid of it, but I've been kicking myself in the ass ever since, man. I think it may have been the rumor that they were racist, and that might have made me get rid of it, but fuck, man. If anyone runs across a Black Funeral Vampyr Throne of the Beast t-shirt, please shoot me a message, because in a size small, preferably. I would kill to have that shirt again. But yeah, if you like that really ugly, gross, you know, LLN, really old school Dark Throne, just that gross, I've recorded my album in a dumpster in the basement of a fucking thick warehouse with echoes and shit. If you like that kind of black metal, but that evil, just ugly sounding black metal, I really feel like this is an album that you need to get into, or at least give a shot, because I think it's absolutely fantastic, and I wish they had stayed on this path and wrote more records like this. But yeah, make sure you check this album out. So that's it for this edition of Metal Monday. If there's any albums you think I need to check out and maybe do for a future Metal Monday, man, throw them in the comment section down there. As usual, thank you for living, thank you for loving, thank you for being you. And I will see you guys next time. Aight? Peace, bitches!